I had to learn how to stop lying.
He knows how many times he's messed up.
And he was my Prince Charming.
I was always nervous that someone would reject me.
So I never, ever was like, oh, I hope I can keep Kristen.
I am the least happy I've ever been in my life.
I think the one thing that a lot of marriages don't have anymore is honesty.
I was ready to jump in, and he was still exploring options.
I knew I had just driven away from something that I was never gonna be able to fix. I'm not granting him any of the forgiveness I would a stranger.
It was the hardest thing I've ever been through by far.
I scared myself so bad.
I never seen anything the same since.
You get to a point in your life where it's like, I'm either going to make these changes or I'm actually going to die.
Dax swore that he would never be like his father.
He was a car salesman who was also an addict. Our weekends with him were spent at a bar, and we would go inside, and from 10 a.m. till midnight, he would just work the broads at the bar with his two kids.
I was really, really resentful at him for not being a dad to me.
The love of my life is my mom, and this is who left her and didn't support her and partied.
But when he was abused by a neighbor as a child, began to spiral.
It took me 12 years to tell anyone that. All that time I was like, it's my fault. I had all these insane thoughts.
As a teenager, he started taking drugs to escape his pain. And when his acting career took off, it only made things worse.
I'm so physically sick that I have to go to the bar. I'm like, I have to get some alcohol down. I'm ordering like Jack and Diet after Jack and Diet. I'm really huddled into the corner because I have been sober up to that point.
For years, Dax had been fighting to overcome his demons.
This is a relapse, and I'm so afraid I'm gonna see someone from AA, and I'm embarrassed how many times I quit and couldn't do it. It's kind of a source of shame for me.
His relapse made him realize he needed to get sober or he'd become his worst nightmare.
I am the least happy I've ever been in my life. I'm closest to not wanting to be alive as I've ever been.
When he got sober for real, he became friends with actor Bradley Cooper, who was also a recovering addict.
I didn't get sober as a hobby. It was more of a necessity.
Dax had found a friend who knew exactly what he was going through.
I wouldn't have been able to have access to myself or other people, or even been able to take in other people if I hadn't changed my life.
If I had it my way, we would do every movie together.
Yeah.
And one night at a dinner party, he met actress Kristen Bell, but they couldn't have been more opposite.
It wasn't love
for either of us, let's just be fair.
I grew up in a very conservative household. Catholic high school is a goody-goody, and I never experimented with drugs.
When they started dating, Dax was intimidated by her goodness.
I wasn't certain I wanted to be with someone like that. That's great, she's good, but that's not what I want to do.
And when Kristen started to learn about his dark past, she began to worry about the future of their relationship.
I met him and he was my Prince Charming, and then, you know, a few months in, this is sort of what challenged us and created some trust issues.
Dax felt like he didn't fit into her perfect world, and so he dumped her.
I was ready to jump in, and he was still exploring options.
I could sense that she was at another place than I was.
But little did Dax know that Kristen was hiding a secret. For years, she had been suffering in silence with depression and anxiety.
I shatter a little bit when I think people don't like me, and I compensate by being very bubbly. I was always nervous right under the surface that someone would reject me.
As Kristen's fears came true, Dax realized that he was about to lose the one, the way his dad lost his mom.
Well, this human being is a good human being. In relationships, when things are getting heated, that's a great, great time for you to take a look at what fear is being triggered.
And he started to see that he wanted to have a life with her.
It's just a better life. And I wanted that. And so I chose to move more in her direction. She didn't ask me to.
But just as Dax and Kristen were building a healthy relationship, he got shocking news from his father.
He calls and says, this thing in my neck is cancer.
Meanwhile, his best friend Bradley had just overcome his own tragedy by dealing with it in a positive way.
Your father passed.
And when he took the last breath, I honestly felt like it went into me, and I never seen anything the same since. And I just started to live my life in a different way.
Dax was inspired to repair his relationship with his dad before it was too late. When Dax took his dad on a trip down memory lane, his dad confessed something that Dax never expected.
We went in front of the apartment that me and my brother and my mom moved into when we left his house. And he goes, I left and I got to that light and I sat on the side of the road right there and I cried for 4 hours. I couldn't drive the car because I knew I had just driven away from something that I was never gonna be able to fix. I drove away and I shouldn't have.
Dax realized the immense amount of shame his father was living with for leaving, and that he had misunderstood his dad all along.
my fantasy was you dropped the couch off, went to the bar and got some ass.
He was just a guy that was scared, and I could see what a little boy he was.
Dax saw his father's vulnerability and knew that he had to let go of his resentment and forgive him.
I'll meet people in recovery who have done terrible things, and I can so easily see past that. I'm not granting him any of the forgiveness I would a stranger who walks into a meeting.
Soon after his father passed away, Dax and Kristen had their first child. Dax should have been over the moon, but something felt wrong.
It's hard to change who you are at your core unless your head's on fire.
But one day, his mom called him with a piece of information that changed his life.
She said, I learned that if you've been molested, you only have a 20% chance of not being an addict.
And it always circles back to shame. It's the most corrosive. And then it leads to more and more behavior that produces more and more shame.
It was then that Dax realized he needed to stop blaming himself for what had happened to him.
There's not a ton to lose. Odds are you're not gonna confront this stuff. I had to learn how to stop lying to myself and tell myself the truth.
By opening up about his shame, Dax was able to forgive himself for his mistakes, and his honesty only made his relationship with Kristen stronger. He helped her learn to let go of her own shame.
Without me, she's never admitting she has depression. That's like something she got from me.
It's very important that we lead honestly and say it's a lot of hard work, yeah. And here's an example of how it can be done.
Today, Dax and Kristen continue to be open about their flaws and experiences to help others.
It's a ton of work. It's not like we bumped into each other and was like, oh, I found the one.
And we love being together because of that work.
And Dax and Bradley keep supporting each other through their growth.
Dax, I mean, he's incredible.
I love Bradley.
It's like you. Love
Dax's story shows us that it's okay to make mistakes, but if you're living in shame, it's hard to move beyond them. And when we forgive ourselves and let go of that shame, we are able to help others forgive themselves too.
How do I fix the foundation that's cracked so that I don't have that desire, you know, that I'm not carrying around shame, that I'm not carrying around resentment?
He knows the value of things. He was an addict for many, many years, and he pulled himself out of it.
And I can honestly say, I'm on fire to be alive.